We've received so many questions, and many of them are similar on similar themes that we've asked Finance Minister and Deputy Prime Minister Grant Robertson onto the show to answer them. We're very grateful that you're here, Deputy Prime Minister. Thank you so much. So these are all viewer questions, and there are. Have you been watching the program this morning? I know you've been very busy,
but. John, you know that I'm glued to every second of breakfast every day.
I would say the merger with RNZ would be off on the strength of our performance.
John, just before we get into the questions, and I'm very happy to answer them, I do just want to do a shout out to the staff who are processing the payments. And, you know, it's an extraordinary effort. I'll just give you one number to indicate that. The Ministry of Social Development staff have processed, up till yesterday, 156,428 applications for the wage subsidy scheme. If you break that down, someone will challenge my maths, I'm sure, it ends up being 21 applications a minute that they are processing. And I just want to say, these are people mostly working from home, working from, you know, their bedrooms doing this, but other New Zealanders. So I just wanted at the start to say, I know there are lots of questions and queries and concerns, but there's a group of people working incredibly hard to get this money out the door. And that's about $575 million that's gone out in 5 days.
Okay, let's stay with that money, because, boy, there's a lot of questions about who is eligible for it. And I have a real sense that some casual workers and part-time workers who have been stood down and desperately need the money to get by are worrying that they're not going to get it or they can't get it. How do they ensure they do, and who is eligible?
So the big thing about the eligibility criteria is that it has not really changed since last year. So in terms of people being worried or confused, if they can take themselves back to where they were March, April, May last year, that criteria, particularly for the wage subsidy scheme, is by and large the same. We'll pop back to the resurgent support payment in a moment. In terms of how it works, if you are a casual worker, your employer can apply on your behalf for the wage subsidy scheme. That is in their power to do that. What they have to do is look at a relatively comparable week from the 6 weeks prior to now and use that as the basis of their application. So the first thing I would say is, if you are a casual worker, you need to be in talking to your employer about access to the wage subsidy scheme. If it turns out that you can't, there's a reason why, there's a particular type of employment arrangement you've got, you need to then be talking to the Ministry of Social Development about what other support you can get. And I'm going to give that phone number out in a minute, John, so that we make sure people know who to call.
So, OK, let's talk about the people who are somehow falling through the cracks. And this is a question from Julie. Thank you, Julie. Who can casual workers who've been in jobs for only a short while before lockdown get in contact with to get support when they're told simply not to come into work? I mean, this is terrible, yeah, isn't it? You're on an hourly rate. You know, boy, you don't even... I mean, and they just say, look, Julie, don't come into work this week. What do you do?
Yeah, so first thing, talk to your employer, because, as I say, if you have been working, even only for a brief period of time, you are eligible for them to apply for on your behalf. That's step one. If for whatever reason your employer won't do that, or you genuinely literally have just started the job like moments ago before lockdown, then you do need to get directly in contact with the Ministry of Social Development. And that phone number, I'll probably do it a few times, 0800 559 009, 0800 559 009. That is when you need to contact directly. But I don't want people who are casualised workers thinking they can't get access to the wage subsidy scheme, because actually their employer can apply for them.
Okay, that's a very important message. What about employers who are telling, and boy, there's so many people, Minister, have contacted us with this question. What about employers who are telling their workers to take annual leave?
They can't. So it's that simple, John. If a person is required to take annual leave, they need to be given 14 days notice. And this is a really important point. Employment law still applies even though we're in COVID. We haven't suddenly thrown out all the rules about how you can be treated fairly. Now, employers and employees can come to agreements about whether or not they want to use up leave and so on, but they cannot be required to take annual leave unless they are given 14 days notice of that.
Okay, and that's not simply the case if you are paying a wage subsidy. That is the case for employers who don't need to claim a wage subsidy. Okay, so that is just a full stop situation. Now, you and I are both confident, stroppy people who can speak up for ourselves with our employers, right? But if you feel there's a real power imbalance, you're being told to take annual leave and you don't know how to say to your employer, actually, Grant Robertson says employment law says I don't have to, what do you do?
Well, you should be a member of a union. That's the first thing I'd say. That's what unions are there for. And I'm quite sure right now today that if people are in those circumstances and they're not members of a union, they should contact the union that covers their workplace to get some support through this. Businesses can, if employees are genuinely feeling this, they can report their businesses through the Ministry of Business, Innovation and Employment to say, this is how I'm being treated. It's outside of employment law. But we're very, very clear about that, John. You cannot force a person to take annual leave unless you've given them 14 days notice that you will be requiring them to do that.
Okay, thank you. We're talking about money as if we were printing it. In fact, the Reserve Bank has been. But this is a really good question from Siok Hang Nguyen, who says, how long will the government be able to support small businesses using things like the wage subsidy? Is there a long-term plan for support? In other words, do you have the money for this?
Yeah, we do, John. And I think the really important thing here is this is what's worked for us. So bear in mind, we did this last year with the wage subsidy scheme, and we came out the other end of it with an economy that's performing better than most others in the world, unemployment down at 4%. So we know this approach works. And the reason it works is it does give people, businesses, cash flow and confidence to keep their employees on. So we will stick with this approach. Our levels of debt as a country are lower than anyone thought they were going to be because the economy has outperformed. And if you just take yourself back a couple of weeks, John, I was doing a host of interviews around the fact that the economy was going so well, we didn't have enough labour force to be able to put ourselves, you know, into the next stage of growth. So we're in a strong position. But more than anything else, John, it's the right thing to do because this strong public health approach that we take is the best economic approach. And therefore, we have to back it with the resources for things like the wage subsidy scheme.
I want to go back to Workers Minister. So far, we've talked about people who are in various forms of master-servant relationships, but actually a lot of questions from people who are contract workers. And I want to cite the example of Grada, who is a lead maternity carer in LMC. So she's contracted to the Ministry of Health. So what do contract workers do? What do sole traders do who aren't in those conventional employer-employee relationships?
Yeah, really good question. And this is where, of course, designing a scheme gets challenging because there are so many different kinds of employment arrangements. If you are your own contractor, you are a sole trader, you are absolutely eligible for all of the schemes to apply in your own right. And I would say, John, of that big number I mentioned before, the 156,000, a big chunk of those are sole traders and contractors. So you absolutely are eligible in those circumstances. It does get a bit more complicated if your arrangement is not you as an independent contractor. And I know because you've had the questions and I've had the questions around early childhood education relievers. That's another area that people have been asking about. That's a really good example of where it gets hard. We employ all the teachers in New Zealand, so we can look after them. But what we don't do is employ all of the early childhood relievers in particular. And so they are going to have a multitude of different arrangements. There we come back to the point. If the centre they work for is experiencing a big revenue drop, parents aren't, you know, bringing their kids in, then they can apply for the scheme. If you're an independent contractor yourself, you can apply under your own scheme. But I recognise that there will be some areas where the scheme doesn't quite work around the edges. Those are the ones where you've got to get on the phone to Inland Revenue if it's the resurgent support payment or MSD and start talking to them about what might be possible, because I think people will understand you can't design the scheme for every single arrangement that sits out there.
And that was directly answering Tina's question, so thank you, Minister. I really appreciate that. I just want to go back to the resurgent support payment, which was kind of where we started. And Samantha asks, why are new businesses not eligible for the resurgent support payment, even though they still have bills coming in that need to be paid?
Yeah, and so the resurgence support payment was something that we brought in late last year, and it was a recognition of those fixed costs. We had to balance that against an integrity measure, which essentially is how do we make sure that, for example, people aren't creating a business in order to get a payment. And the Auditor General was all over us, John, about the wage subsidy scheme, whether it was too generous and what rules we had in place, and we've strengthened that. So the resurgence support payment kind of fitted around that. We used a definition around what we called a viable business, and we had to set some kind of time frame that the business had been in operation. What I would say to anybody who was in those circumstances, though, is the wage subsidy scheme doesn't have that 6 month qualification period, so you can still apply for that, as you can for those shorter term schemes, which are about people who are waiting for a COVID test or have to isolate because they've got COVID. Those two ones are available too for the range of businesses.
Minister, we got through a heap of questions and lots of them were recurring from lots of different people. We really appreciate your time this morning. Thank you so much for joining us.
Cheers, John.
I do want to say, if people feel like their employer is not giving the money that they're entitled to, if you are a contract worker and you're not receiving wage subsidy or any kind of support, and you feel like your employer is taking the piss, to be frank, or you are being told to take annual leave, get in contact with us and we'll make calls. Breakfast at tvnz.co.nz.